Welcome to Behind the Curtain. I'm Joe White.
And I'm Katy Shander-Reynolds.
Welcome to another episode of Behind the Curtain, Ashland Community Theater. So, how are you doing, Katy?
I'm doing all right. How are you doing, Joe?
I am doing fantastic now
that
I am back.
It's a beautiful day today.
It's like 60 degrees in February. This is crazy. It broke the record, I think, today.
Did it?
I think so.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. So, we are here today to talk about a bunch of things. We have the cast to the wonderful scene called Soup to Nuts. Mm-hmm. Who wrote that?
It was written by, if the name comes to me, I'll bring it in later.
It's actually you wrote it, didn't you?
I did.
Yeah, Soup to Nuts, written by you. And we have some of the cast members here today. Who do we have?
About half. So today we have Jack Corbett, who played Evan.
Ooh.
And we have Krystyanna Greaves, who played Delia.
Ooh.
And then we have Arnie Pollinger back.
Back?
For the second episode in a row.
Oh, can't get rid of him.
Yes.
Yeah, they're here
who
today.
Wants to?
And unfortunately, Maddie Schott, Steve Lillis, and Juliana Miller could not make it here today. But then they sent
some people have lives.
They do. So what do we have on our docket for Ashland Community Theater coming up? What's coming up in June?
In June, we have our spring show.
What is it called?
It is called Two Acts of Murder.
That's awesome. That's
going to
be great. So it's going to be two different acts of a murder.
Yeah.
Wow. So it's going to be two different
two acts. Murders.
Two murders.
In two different acts.
Have you seen the scripts?
I have.
That's awesome.
I have, yes.
Who did the murder?
If I tell them now, they won't come to the show.
Do you murder me or do I murder you?
They'll have to show up and see.
Okay. Are you even in it?
Who knows? I have to audition tonight.
Tonight's the audition?
Yes.
When were people going to tell me these things?
So auditions are happening like right now.
Oh, my goodness.
In the next 10 days.
Yes.
And then the show goes up June, I believe, 1st, 2nd, and 3rd.
Correct.
Uh-huh. And where is the show happening?
It's in Ashland.
In Ashland somewhere.
Yes, it's probably going to be.
Part of the mystery.
You got to find where the murder is.
Yes,
and then it's
going
to have you go all around town. You start at the Dunkin', then you go to the 135.
Then go to the other Dunkin'.
And
then
you go to CVS. You wait online for about 2 hours waiting for your prescription. But you're ready to have it.
That's okay. That's okay. We can make like a scavenger hunt.
Yes,
find the murder.
Find the murder. Now, right now, fingers crossed, it's at the Ashland Middle School Theater right now.
Okay.
Right now, fingers crossed.
Could be. Knows?
But we are working on some other opportunities that we may have, that we're going to have some meetings over the month of March and April that we could potentially have a more permanent location.
That would be very
exciting. To do our shows.
Home.
Our own home.
Yes, we would like
and
that.
A little bit more flexibility. Schools have been great, don't mind, but I think it's a little bit more flexible. But any other great stories you want to talk about that you have tonight? You got any bird stories like last year?
No, no birds.
You
haven't rescued
bird?
Any animals recently.
No animals.
No. We've been busy buying cars.
Yeah, well,
yeah.
Come
we
on.
Bought
you
two
have
cars
so much
recently.
Money. You have so much money to buy
animals.
Oh,
I have no money now.
What'd you buy?
Well, let's see. My son.
No, wait, are they a sponsor for ACT?
Unfortunately, they are not.
Oh, unfortunately. No.
My youngest got his license. And living out here, you have to have a car. So we gave him our old Subaru and got a newer Subaru.
That's good.
Which is fun. It's a standard shift, which I haven't driven in a long time, so it makes me feel young. And then my husband had a Volkswagen that was part of that big scandal with the exhaust.
Ooh.
And so we had to return that, and then we had to buy a new car because he can't not have a car. So we went and bought a Chevy Volt.
Excellent.
So we have an electric car, which is kind of cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah, we can go down to town hall and plug it in.
Maybe you can write a show about that.
Oh, that'd be fun.
Car dealerships.
Yeah.
101.
Well,
listen, let's go watch that wonderful scene of yours from Dinner Conversations from this past fall.
Fall show.
It was a great show.
Soup to Nuts.
Why don't you sit back, relax, and watch the show. And when you come back, we'll have three of the actors from the scene, and Katie's got wonderful questions that she's going to ask them. Really funny questions, I hear.
Welcome to us all. Do you have a reservation?
Oh, it's okay. He knows that we're friends.
Oh, that's good. It's hard pretending not to know you when you bring a first day here. Nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you, too.
Hi, Delia. I'll show you to your table. Follow me. Here we are. Table for two. Enjoy.
So, where would you like to sit?
Well, I know it probably sounds silly, but I don't like to sit with my back to the room.
In fact, that doesn't sound silly at all. I feel the same way.
Oh, well, then...
Well, how about you sit here? And I'll sit right here. And now we both can feel comfortable.
And we can watch everybody else and talk about them without being overheard.
Two things we already have in common. So, you probably already know what's good here.
Oh, well, everything's good here. I've had it all more than once. I mean, not that I bring all my first dates here. I mean, not that I have that many first dates.
That's all right. I don't count up my own first dates either. It would be depressing. Well, not that I haven't had enough, and not that I have had so many.
Can I offer you something to drink tonight? I can also answer any questions you might have for the menu.
What are you thinking? A glass of wine or something non-alcoholic?
A glass of wine would be perfect. Have you selected something in particular?
No. I'm sorry to admit that I really don't know anything about wine.
Oh, thank goodness, neither do I. The house Chianti is very nice.
Shall we risk a bottle?
Sure, let's be daring. So I guess we should order red meat or red sauce to go with the red wine.
Mm-hmm. Ah, Chianti is red wine. I'm slightly less ignorant now.
This one seems like a real possibility.
Really?
First of all, he's polite. Let her walk to the table first.
Are you sure he was not just checking out her?
Oh, no. He thought you to drop a napkin, and he stopped to pick it up.
So clearly he was not leering at her derriere. That's a good sign.
Oh, man, he didn't bother her facing the room today.
So, no sarcastic comments about her paranoia and why it was. Sounds promising.
And he knows nothing about wine.
Not a drunk, nor a snob.
Cross your fingers.
Does soup count?
I'm sorry?
For the whole wine thing, should one order tomato soup to go with red, chicken soup with white? I happen to love soup and I don't want to make an embarrassing mistake ordering the wrong kind.
I love soup too. I can have it at every meal.
No kidding. I'll tell you a secret then. I sometimes have soup for breakfast.
Oh, so does Delia. It's true. If you want to try an amazing egg soup, I will give you my recipe.
Jerry, didn't you feed the meters?
Well, it's after 6 o'clock. I don't have to.
Well, there's a new bylaw in town, and you feed the meters on the weekends until 8 p.m.
So go put some money in the meter, then.
I don't have any money. You go.
What do you mean you don't have any money?
Why would I have any money? You wasted money on poker and gambling.
Oh, dear! Something came up and they changed their reservation to tonight. And the only open table is next to Delia and her new man.
No, we can't do that to her. It's going so well.
I am afraid we have no choice. I don't know why you made our reservation for Friday night. I could be missing out on a big win at poker tonight.
Don't be ridiculous. You've never once had a big win at poker.
Bonsoir, madame, monsieur Morris. How are you?
About as well as could be expected, considering I'm missing my poker game.
We'll have our usual table, Jacques.
Unfortunately, Mrs. Morris, your usual table is not available this evening. Michelle will take you to your table.
Really? You would think we would merit some consideration around here? I mean, after all, we come here every single week.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Morris. Follow me, please.
And your poker games. All you do is throw our money away and come home stinking like booze and cigars.
You spend hundreds of dollars on useless dreck on the shopping channel, and I play poker.
What is this plant doing here? This plant shouldn't be here. Who put this plant here?
I'm out of here, Mrs. Morris. I'm so sorry.
Get rid of it. Get rid of it. Oh, my gosh.
Well, why don't you just sit in a different seat?
Well, I didn't want to have to sit so close to you.
What do you think? You're a mob don waiting for someone to shoot you or something?
You are so funny, Mr. Morris.
And what has gotten into you this evening?
So, tell me something about yourself, other than your love of people watching and soup, that is.
Oh, well,
Wow, this soup is outstanding.
I'm glad you like it.
I'll start with the soup.
Well, bring me something crunchy then to drown out his slurping noises.
You
and your soup. You had to go and pass that weird obsession along to our son. No wonder he's not married.
You were too much tonight.
Something's wrong with her tonight. She's usually so quiet.
You know, I wonder if she's been drinking. Drinking on the job? She should be fired. Where's Tony, anyway?
Those two are going to drive me to drink. Give me a shot of tequila.
You are working.
Hand up a shot or you go deal with that.
Has the game gone sour already? It would not be the record. Do you remember that time?
No. I mean, the more steak.
They are awful.
How are we going to keep them from poisoning Delia's steak?
Well, if your brilliant plant scheme did not work, I do not know what else can be done.
Joe, you don't know what it's like living with her when a date goes badly. If she doesn't get a second date, I'm going to live on your sofa for the next month.
Relax. Don't be so dramatic.
Wow, it sounds like the nightlife has started. Would you like to dance?
I do love dancing.
Me too. Maybe we can go to a club next time.
What on heaven's name is that going on? Turn that music down!
There was a time when loud music make you want to dance.
Well, that was before you and your two left feet would embarrass me at every club in town.
You're so funny! Can I get something else for you this evening?
Yeah, how's the roast beef tonight? Well done, I hope.
What kind of a question is that? Do you think that they cook it in advance and leave it to get cold?
That's a good one. The roast beef looks wonderful, Mr. Morse.
I'll take the roast beef, and not too well done, and not cold.
Well, I'll take the herb-roasted chicken with crispy potatoes, not soggy, and don't overcook the asparagus.
What do you think? She's the cook and the waitress?
I'll be back with your dinners. Enjoy this lovely evening. Whew. Do you know what would be great? If there was a club that served fun soups and played great dance music.
Wow, that sounds like the perfect place. For you and me, anyway. And if it was just the two of us, even better.
Wow, that's the nicest thing anyone has said to me in a long time.
It could be called Souped Up.
Great idea!
Can I offer anyone anything for dessert? We have a blueberry cheesecake.
Are you insane?
Where are our entrees? We haven't had our entrees yet.
That strawberry thing looks awful yummy.
Are you going to fall for this craziness? You are such a pushover.
I am not a pushover. I'm hungry. I'll eat dessert before dinner. That way I can get away from you sooner.
Get that cart away from here. Go find out where our dinners are.
Oh, of course, if nobody's at the club, then we can't do any people watching.
That's all right. We'd be too caught up in our Charleston chowder to care.
And when we're finished with our moonwalk minestrone, we'll have the whole dance floor to ourselves.
That sounds like the perfect evening to me.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Oh, this is crazy. What in the world?
So what if it's not our birthday?
Jerry, get up. We're leaving. This restaurant has gone to the dogs.
Mom and Dad?
Evan, what on earth are you doing here?
I'm on a date. This is Delia. Delia, these are my parents.
It's very nice to meet you both.
Nice to meet you, too. Did you have the soup?
Yes, I always do. I love soup.
Oh, I do, too. Follow me. I taught Evan everything he knows about soup.
Evan, how could you come here with such a nice girl? She's going to run from you screaming. The service here is beyond horrible.
Nice save?
I think it's waiter Ophelia's best ever first date.
This night went from soup to nuts in a big hurry.
All I can say is, I need another shot.
Welcome back.
It was a great scene. Can you believe that?
It's an awesome scene.
I love that
they
scene.
They did a great job.
What made you write that scene? Because you were the artists.
Oh my gosh, I don't remember what made me write it. Well, then, so let's see, you came up with, we had the idea that it was going to be scenes in a restaurant.
Yes.
Yes. And I thought, oh, wouldn't it be funny to do a scene about a first date that goes really badly?
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, what would make a first date go badly? And that would be if there were other patrons in the restaurant who were really horribly behaved. And then I don't know how it developed from there. And then somebody came up with that awesome twist.
I don't remember what it was. It was one of us sitting here that's not... I don't remember.
Jack or Arnie.
John or Arnie or Krystyanna or you. Speaking of Jack.
There's Jack right Jack? There. And I don't mean Jacques. I mean Jack.
Oh, this is Jacques? This is Jacques?
Yeah. There's Jack.
Jack Corbett. Now, we'll talk about how we got him roped into this fine mess we've got ourselves into.
Yeah.
Arnie Pollinger, Mr. Jacques. Jack.
That's Jacques. Jacques to you. First of all, wait a minute. I need to address the elephant in the room, okay?
Excuse me, I've lost a little weight.
These chairs, all right, look at this. Right there.
Yep.
And right
there. Yep. Specifically designed to make you feel
it's based upon how much better they were in the scene.
Well,
so
all right. They are up to
see. That's just the way it works.
No, I am naturally if it was me, I'd be on the floor. Person, but this is just making me.
You're not short. You're vertically challenged.
I am a
big difference.
Okay, thank you.
None of us are particularly
vertical challenge. There's a difference there.
Anyway, so that's I can sit up straight, but I'm naturally a slouch.
You know what, the audience was wondering last time why you had the higher chair, so we had to put you in the lower one this time to
balance things out.
That's right. And then finally we get to Krystyanna Greaves because we never got past you to talk to her. What a great cast it was.
Yeah, thanks so much for coming, you guys.
Yeah.
Of course. To talk about the scene again.
Yeah. Sure. You have a bunch of questions for these wonderful people.
I do. I wrote down some questions.
Wow.
Sitting out of my deck today. It was nice
27
and warm and
shows
sunny.
She's prepared for this one.
Hey, listen. I'm a late bloomer. But you said you had a question for me first.
I did.
Was that the one you already asked me?
I already did, and you already answered.
So I can move on? You're all done.
We're
done with Joe.
For now.
Okay.
Except for this one. I have one.
So I have some questions for you guys.
Okay.
You didn't get to look at yours first. I'll
he was too busy worrying about the height of the chair
over there.
Really? They prepped.
They prepped.
What did you email them?
They got here early. They got here early. All right. So Krystyanna and Jack. Number one question: how do you feel about soup? Like, do you actually like soup in real life?
I do. I'm actually really particular to clam chowder.
Clam chowder. That's good as a New Englander.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
important.
New England or Manhattan?
Chowder.
New England.
Oh, God. It wouldn't even occur to me to ask somebody that, because how could anybody prefer Manhattan clam?
No.
That's not even clam chowder.
No.
Let's not go there. What about you?
Yeah, I like soup. Yeah. I really like Italian wedding soup.
That's a good one. Do you actually make soup at home, ever?
I have never made soup at
it's
home,
It's so
actually.
Easy. I'll have to tell
you. Yeah,
it's
you
so
open
easy.
The can,
you put it right into the and you heat it up.
Add a little water sometimes.
Yeah.
Keep forgetting the water.
Then there's the powdered stuff with the boiling water.
Yeah.
What about you, Jack? Do you cook? All the eligible young ladies out there want to know. Does Jack Corbett cook?
Not really.
No.
Not really.
It's not too late to learn.
I could fend for myself if I had to.
That's good. You can boil an egg.
I can boil an egg.
You can make noodles.
Can make mac and cheese. Okay.
This is good. That's a start. That's cooking.
Some essentials.
That counts. That counts as cooking.
Nothing fancy though.
But did either one of you know the soups that she came up with in the script?
Yeah.
Well, they had interesting names.
Yeah. they had interesting names that were off of.
I don't even remember what we.
Real soup.
Well, they were soups and then real dances.
Right.
Yeah.
Did you know the dances?
Get up and do them right
the
now.
Charleston chowder.
So it was a Charleston chowder. What was it? We just watched
Moonwalk Minestrone. Who can do the moonwalk?
Moonwalk Minestrone.
Can you do the moonwalk now?
Michael Jackson.
Yeah, Michael Jackson.
The Minestrone or the moonwalk?
All right.
Okay, let's move on.
Who
got one for you.
Who's
you ready? You ready?
The guy in the shorter chair?
What do you think that Jacques did in his free time?
Oh, it was easy. He went over to the strip club around the corner.
Oh my God. Yeah, that's
right?
True.
Yeah, to the
that's
strip
true.
Club.
When he had those good tips, especially.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Yeah. I think Evan gave him a good tip that day, too.
He's a weird dude. He looked at women's magazines. I don't know if anybody caught that on the show or in the audience.
A lot of people wrote in about that.
Yeah.
Like, want to know what you were reading, the cupcake. Everybody
Twinkie.
Some people saw the cupcake during the rehearsals, we're just saying.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Very good. All right, so back to our young people. So I haven't been on a first date since before either of you were born. So I had some questions for you guys about, you know, dating. And what do you think about that as a first date? Like, as you were, you know, going through the production and up there on stage acting out this first date, what were you really thinking, like, about it as a date?
Oh, I don't want to contradict your directing.
No, please do. Somebody must. Somebody must speak up, and if it's not me, it's got to be you. Because she can't get you because she's got to get through me. Please be honest.
Yeah, you just you kept asking for more sappiness in the scene, mm-hmm. and I felt like it was just going from like 0 to 60, full on in love, pretty quick.
Well, that was kind of the point. Yeah, that was the way it was supposed to go.
To be a great contrast to the other.
Yeah, it wasn't supposed to be particularly realistic.
Yeah.
You know?
So that's what I'm saying. I don't think that's super realistic.
Definitely wasn't. Yeah. I was like, I also probably wouldn't. I would have noticed some of the things that were going on rather than being totally unaware.
So, Arnie, have you ever worked in a restaurant?
Yeah, it was my first job. Oh my God, it was horrible.
So, what did you do in this restaurant?
I was a dishwasher until. Although one of the cooks burned his finger or something like that, and they were short-staffed, so that I got,
promoted really fast.
You got promoted from dishwasher to cook.
Exactly.
Because the guy burned his finger.
I was in charge of the fried mushrooms, I guess it was.
Oh. Yeah. What kind of restaurant was it?
It was like a deli. Okay. It was open like till 4 a.m, and they had a bar.
Okay.
You know, it was the 70s, you can get away with that. And it was fun. I was in charge of the fried mushrooms.
But you never looked for another restaurant job again, I guess.
No.
No, you were one and done.
Yeah, it's not really for me.
But it was okay acting in a restaurant.
Oh, on stage. I'm an acting slut. I'll do anything.
Really? Really? Are you really?
Comedy.
Are you really gonna say? I'm sorry.
Comedy.
You just said.
Comedy.
Oh, see. You kind of. No.
Yeah, yeah.
He's
not
contradicting himself.
I do have standards.
I'll do anything. But it's got to be comedy.
So then that isn't true.
Well, I'm a comedy slut.
Oh, God, so many things.
All right. So, Krystyanna.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
You've done a lot of performing. Acting, dancing. You come from this family of like very well-known stage people. And I'm wondering, did it ever occur to you to be like the one who rebels as the Greaves, not to be on stage? Or is it like it's this family thing, you know, like family that plays together, stays together. Well, with the Greaves, it's the family that does plays together, stays together.
I probably wouldn't ever like stop performing, because that's what I want to do, but
do your parents get the credit for that, or is it like
for like me performing?
Was it growing up around people who were so involved in theater?
Probably,
and, yeah.
But my parents are also just very artistic people that I kind of like. It's in me, so it was bound to happen. But I probably wouldn't ever stop. But I do a lot of stuff like with my dad because he does a lot of community theater. But right now I'm working on something that my dad has nothing to do with it. It's just me.
How does that feel? How does that feel?
It's good.
So you're not like climbing ladders and setting up lights like you were for this show?
No. I was not.
Poor Krystyanna got dragged into all the tech stuff, too.
Krystyanna made the sign for Wessons that was out, that was hanging. She made
awesome.
That sign.
I did.
She did it. And I remember I was over in your dad's house when you were doing that, and he was given like do this, and you're like, Dad, that won't work. Dad, do this. Yeah, that won't work. And she was right. And she did, and it was perfect.
So where is that sign now?
It's in my basement right now, getting ready for the future filmings.
Okay.
It's there. Yeah, we keep all the props for when we get our
all the good ones.
In your basement.
Community theater.
Mostly.
Yeah, mostly in the basement, It's with me now, because I bring so much stuff home, my wife lets me stay in the basement.
All right.
Now, Jack. I got a question for Jack.
Oh, you can ask Jack.
Can I ask Jack a question?
Yeah, I can wait.
I know you have tons of questions.
That's all right. I have my list.
There,
I'm ready.
So you were at work one day, just minding your own business, thinking that things were going to be just any other day. Jack and Katy work together, by the way. They're both teachers in Framingham.
That's correct.
Right? And we won't get into the details about what grades and stuff, but what do you teach them? But how, all of a sudden, you're sitting there, and all of a sudden, this one comes up and says what? To you about
So I'm the music teacher at our school. Katie's class happens to come down every Wednesday morning for first period for music. So as the kids were walking in, I was ambushed a little bit, kind of in my zone for the day.
Ambushed?
The lesson.
Ambushed. Let me just get that right. I've never heard ambushed. Nice. Did she say
ambushed?
I heard that. I heard ambushed. Okay. Go ahead.
And she said that she happened to be involved in some community theater and that they had somebody that was going to play the role that I ended up playing. But they weren't able to make it, so she asked if I had any interest in being a good person. Also, I think it'd be a pretty good challenge for me. I said I'd look into it, and sure enough, I ended up doing the scene.
Wow, ambushed! I can't get
listen.
It.
I thought, you know what? I'm just gonna get right out there and ask him. I'm not gonna pussyfoot around
no,
and you know
no,
send
no,
emails, with these cryptic messages, and
no, no,
I'm just gonna ask.
No,
why him?
Vibes.
No offense. I mean, no,
okay.
You were great. You were great.
Well,
what made
so
you
what made me think of Jack?
Yeah,
so what happened was we had the open call, and there were several young men, and so the role was offered to this one young man, who proceeded to not show up.
We know who he
for
is,
several
but we're
weeks.
Not gonna name
no,
him.
No, there's no need to name.
No, no.
But it was just he never showed up. I never heard from him. I reached out several times. I had no idea what happened to this kid. And
should have ambushed him.
There was a moment of panic where we realized, okay, you know, we're really starting to cut it close. We need someone else to take on this
day.
Role because this person has disappeared. And I thought, okay, so I need a young man to play a nice young man on a date. I don't know why I immediately thought, Jack.
Wow.
Because Jack, as a Jack, Jack is,
I like, he's got to qualify. It was a handsome young man.
Jack is a musician.
Yes.
So he's used to performing.
Yep.
He's a teacher, so he's used to talking in front of people, and he's great with the kids. And I thought if he's great with kids, he'd be great on stage. And he's personable, and I thought he'd be fun to work with because I enjoy working with him at our day
job. Was that your first time on stage?
Doing theater since I was since I was in school myself.
Right. Yeah. So and you worked with Krystyanna, who's been on stage an awful lot. Did you get any tips from each other?
I was certainly asking.
Yes. scrambled eggs. You were telling the people in the back. And they'd give out ham and eggs, whatever.
Peas and carrots.
That's what I said.
Did I say that?
Scrambled eggs.
That's kind of funny. The thing that I thought was the most challenging was actually not the lines, but we were supposed to do like in between the lines. And so we're in the restaurant, and there's a lot of downtime where we're sitting, reading the menus.
Falling in love.
Gazing
into each other's eyes.
But I've been rehearsals.
What am I doing now?
Yeah. What am I supposed to do right now? So it was good to have somebody that was experienced to lead me in the right direction.
Whether it was in the right direction or not.
I thought it worked out very well, so.
So for a newbie and a person, just one more question. I'm just curious from my own perspective. When you're on stage with a multiple cast, five or six people, right? It's different because when you're saying, then all of a sudden the action goes away to the Bickersons, right? And then all
his
of a sudden,
parents be nice. It's with his parents.
That's right. And then you got Arnie doing things. People bringing trees over. You guys, to me, I've always found it more difficult when that is all going on to say, okay, I got my mind is actually racing right now. Oh my God, I got to remember my lines coming up pretty soon. Was that more difficult versus being in a scene with just two people? Then you're there. If you stop talking and the other one stopped talking, you know, would you align pretty much?
I don't know. We rehearsed it so many times and got it down so that you know you kind of get the feel of the flow of everything and the cue, so that you don't want to be thinking about it all the time, because then you just look like you're thinking about what to do next instead of being in the scene and talking to that person that you're with. So I didn't feel like it was that hard. I mean, after we rehearsed it a lot, and I think what was hard about that was that we didn't know what some of our cues were because we had to wait until we were on the stage the week of to see like how long it was going to take for the tree to come over, for the cart to come out, and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But once we got it, I think it went pretty well.
The stage was a lot bigger than Maddie's dining room.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, she's got a very big dining room. Oh, we have a very small stage. I was just curious about that.
Mm-hmm. So I have a question for you as Ginny's dad.
Yeah.
Back to the whole dating thing. So would you want Ginny to date someone like Evan?
Ooh. Oh my God!
I hope
Ginny's
watching.
Yeah, compared to her usual. Ginny, I'm just kidding. Ginny and
wait a second, can we get that on tape? Is this on tape? Is that, that's, we filmed.
That
we're
was
filming.
It was a setup, Ginny. I apologize. We'll talk. Call me. Yeah, sure, Jerry, you know,
yeah.
How can you complain about a guy? Like, people like him don't exist. And his character.
He doesn't exist? Yeah. You mean Evan doesn't exist?
He was an,
Jack
an ideal, idealized yeah. character. How do you think, how did Evan turn out so nice with those parents?
I think that there's something in Evan that he just has this perception of the world that hasn't been jaded yet. He's still young enough that he sees love for being true love and is an idealist in that sense. And so
doesn't want to be
despite,
like
despite maybe what he's grown up seeing,
right.
he still has another vision for what's out there. And
although, you know, it was incongruous because your mom was Maddie, you know, who was
yeah.
like, you know, yeah. I mean, she was great. She cracked me up constantly. But, you know, so with your home life,
yeah.
you know.
Maybe he left the house early. He
yeah.
probably flew the coop pretty young.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
yeah that would explain. Get out.
So we should probably explain the whole Ginny's dad thing. I realized this after the last episode.
I think we
so
should keep the audience.
You like
waiting.
The mystery?
Yeah.
We can add
part
it.
Of the
we can
June
add
thing.
It to the scavenger hunt. Yeah.
Ooh,
the
nice
Ginny's
idea.
Dad.
Okay.
Two acts of murder scavenger hunt.
Yes.
Two acts.
Okay.
We'll change the name. How was it to work with a large cast as a director?
Well, it was my first time directing for the stage. So I don't have anything
so
to compare it to.
So you've never worked with a larger or smaller cast before?
No.
That?
In fact, that is exactly the case. Yes. But I enjoyed it. I mean, I think it was challenging at first where we didn't have that one actor. And it was hard to keep asking people to come to rehearsals when we didn't
right.
have a whole cast and we couldn't really do a full rehearsal. But once Jack was on board, it went really smoothly. I thought the cast was very easy to work with. Everybody was really friendly and personable and willing to do all the stupid things I asked them to do.
We got a great question. What was the stupidest thing she's asked you to do besides being mushy?
Because
she
the
said
line?
There were stupid things. I'm just following up on the question. You opened that line of questioning. That I. What was the stupidest thing she asked you to do?
Hmm.
If there was one, maybe
yeah,
she
it wasn't stupid, although the funniest thing was, I remember it was at one of the dress rehearsals, it was Juliana, right?
Yeah.
So there's this tree, this fake tree, that's supposed to be really heavy. So she's at one point she's dragging up. Oh, people have seen it, right?
Yeah.
So she's dragging across the stage, right? And then, you know, I come out and I'm supposed to put it back. My role, you know. So I pick it up, Ronnie, you know, I can't run. You know. And so it was just a rehearsal. You know, you
yeah.
come up to me afterward and you're like, you know, that's supposed to be a heavy tree and it's kind of incongruous for you to just lift it up and go over there. And people were wondering, it's like, right.
Make
yeah.
it look heavy. Just make it look heavy.
Try to be realistic. Yeah.
That is kind of funny though. If she was struggling with that, and you just pick it up with your hand and just walk away. It's kind of
yeah,
cute.
Yeah,
but I get it.
Different kind of funny.
Yeah. What about you, Krystyanna? What was the direction that you got that was that either worked or helped?
I don't think there was anything like silly that really stuck out.
Okay.
I mean, it was
there was
just
a lot of gaze into each other's eyes.
Yeah, it was
gaze.
A lot of
gaze.
Oh, God. Yeah, you had to, like, channel your, like, inner rom-com.
Yeah. Corny, corny rom-com.
Yeah.
That's what I was after.
So are Evan and
Delia
dating now?
Delia.
I mean, not in real life, but in the, if Soup the Nuts were continuing on, would they be going out on a second date?
What do you think? After meeting the parents?
I mean, it can only get better from there.
Yeah.
Would you ever go back to Wesson's?
I don't see why not. The soup was good.
Soup
yeah, yeah.
was good.
And the music.
Yeah.
Yeah. The service was impeccable.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Ooh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely
yeah.
wonderful.
What else you got in that long list of questions?
Let's see. I think I've... I think it's all kind of been touched upon.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here's one for you, Jack.
Uh-oh, be careful.
What, if anything, about this experience was better than your day job?
Wow, what was better than my day job? Well, working with kids, we try to, well, in music class, I guess we try to do a lot of the similar stuff where we're trying to get people to collaborate and think about stuff and create a kind of lens. But working with adults was a lot easier because I don't have to pre-teach how to actually talk to each other and how to carry out certain things. So it was nice to be able to just kind of be prepared myself and come to rehearsals with everyone else being prepared and also having really thoughtful ideas about how the scene should go and having a very professional sense about the whole thing.
Good answer, good answer.
Did you have people come see the show? Could you have people come? What did they think of it? What they think of the show slash the scene itself that you were in?
They really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Right. I think they really enjoyed the scene.
Good.
Yeah. I think it was a funny scene.
Oh, it was great.
I like the slapstick comedy.
Yeah. Oh, it was fun. I love playing off characters. So Maddie and Steve, playing off of them.
Yeah.
Being able to react to them. That's what really gets me. That was fun.
Yeah.
What was your favorite line in the scene that you said? I always ask that question. I know my favorite Arnie line in that scene.
Really?
Yeah.
I haven't really thought about it in a while. Let's see. I don't know. I always like the, unfortunately, Mrs. Moss, your usual table is not available this evening. And then, I look back, Michelle, and then I look and see the tree, and everything's weird. It's just kind of a weird reaction, and I sort of back up. So it's not really a line, but more like the reaction to them. I don't know what your favorite was.
What?
You always like the one where Jacques says, if your brilliant plant scheme didn't work.
Yes, exactly. I love that one. Your brilliant plant scheme didn't work.
I love that one.
It cracks me up now. Just thinking Favorite line?
It's probably the corniest line that I have to say. And it's at the climax of falling in love where we finally look into each other's eyes and take each other's hands. And I make a comment about how this restaurant for our next date that has great dance music and soups could be called Soup. Every time I'm just like, come on. It's so bad.
Yeah.
Very
cool.
Very
cool.
That was a good one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have one, Krystyanna?
I didn't have a lot of funny lines. Jack Moore had more.
So you were the straight person in the scene.
But my favorite was when Juliana, who played the waitress, mentioned that I eat soup for breakfast too. And then I had to throw it away as like, oh yeah, I'm not crazy.
I like when Steve, the man who played, what was the husband's name?
Mr. Morse
came up to you and goes, do you have soup? You like soup? I like soup all the time. And it was just like you were in a connecting, bonding over
soup.
He was
about to tell me the history.
Exactly. I loved it. It was just so great.
Well, it's funny because we're actually in rehearsal and Steve, it wasn't all the time, but there was one small section of the rehearsal process where he kept missing, because I say something about soup, and then he takes off of, oh, I was listening for the soup, and he says, oh, I'll have the soup. Right. He over here on the table, but he kept missing it, so we were just laughing at him, an inside joke, oh, the soup!
Now, you were at the cast party, you were talking to Steve pretty much, I think, at the cast party, and I think then we tried to talk you into doing the music for dinner conversations if we're moving ahead with the filming of it and this thing. So they were downstairs chatting for a while, and then you guys came back up. So did you bond with anybody else on the cast or anybody else in the other scenes that you met with?
Well, I certainly met a lot of people. We talked a little bit, in between when we had all the dress rehearsals, we were all backstage, and then at the cast party. And I was an extra in another scene, and I'm blanking on her first name.
Jane.
She was really nice, and so...
Yes.
Our extras, or part of being an extra, was we were supposed to make conversation on the stage, and we actually made small talk on the stage and got to know each other pretty well after we went through it a couple times. And she was really nice.
Great.
She
was great.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Good times.
Wrap up questions.
All right. So I guess you could all answer this, even though you're like I am. I think you haven't been on a date in a long time because you're married like I am. But what would you do differently on a first date, if you were actually on a first date?
Dude,
not in a corny rom-com stage situation.
Hmm.
What if you were Delia and you were actually on a first date, would you do anything differently?
Like different than what she did?
Different than what she did in that situation. Like you were saying, you would have noticed some of the things that were going on. Would you maybe have said, let's get out of here and go somewhere else? This place is weird.
Probably.
Yeah, yeah.
I would have been like, let's move tables like to more, to like a corner.
Let's move tables to the restaurant down the block. We'll be out of here in no time. That's what we're going to
do. Probably.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you would just leave.
No.
I'm out.
Would you bring Evan with you?
That's right. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I wouldn't just leave.
Excuse me, I'm getting up. There's no soup here. No soup for you! Do you remember that from Seinfeld?
Soup Nazi.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Okay, excuse me, can I have bread with that? No!
I don't know. For my first date, I'm not much of a wine drinker to begin with, so I don't know if I go to such a fancy place on my first date. Not that I don't like not fancy things. I can't be okay with that.
Sounds like he's talking about it. Not that I don't like that. Yeah. It's like your character. You're like, yeah, that doesn't
matter. Yeah. Trying to back myself out of that one. I don't know.
You'd pick up the napkin, wouldn't you?
I would. Yeah. Most likely pay more like I did in the scene.
Mm.
Oh, that's like, are you sure he was not just checking out?
Yeah, yes, that was
good
luck.
I forgot about that thing.
There
it
is.
There
was no, I was not. Yeah. Now, I'd ask again, but I think, would you guys be in another show? Knowing that you're here tonight to audition and you're here tonight to read an audition, even though it's not a comedy, you still may be convinced because we could turn it into a comedy. Who knows? And then... Krystyanna has been with us for a while now. She was one of the first people I fired as Hultquist.
That's right.
One of my favorite scenes is where we just got right and walked her right out in the scene of you just like just walking her right out and then you're fired. And then she's been on stage with us. So thank you guys very much for coming down, taking some time out of your day and filming with us here today.
Thanks for having me. And, by the way,
yeah,
you didn't ask, but April 3rd,
April 3rd, yes.
The
Amazing
Arts Center
in
Framingham.
Are you?
Well, they don't know it yet, but I will be performing stand-up there.
Oh, April 3rd.
It's a Monday
Wednesday?
No, it's a Wednesday. The first Wednesday of every month, they have open mic stand-up.
Oh, cool.
So it would actually be next Wednesday.
April 3rd?
But
April 3rd's not a Wednesday.
You sure?
You said April.
Right. Yeah, it is April. You sure it's not a Wednesday?
April 14th is a Friday. The 7th is a Friday. So the 6th and the 5th, the 4th, the 3rd is a Monday. April 3rd is a Monday. I'm sorry.
Maybe it's the 5th. April 5th.
April 5th. That's
okay.
A different day.
First Wednesday.
It's a different day. Different time. I'm a Rain Man guy. I know dates.
First Wednesday.
My daughter would be very upset.
In April.
First Wednesday in April.
Yeah. I would do it next week, but unfortunately I have to go skiing.
Oh,
wait. You're saying you have to go skiing?
Yeah.
Can you post more Facebook pictures of you skiing? Because I don't get enough of those.
Yeah, I will do that. All
right. So let's get it back up. Arnie's going to be where on
Amazing Arts Center.
April
5th.
April 5th.
Doing stand-up.
Stand-up.
April 5th.
Well, let's put this
in. I may be doing stand-up elsewhere before then, but I'm not going to tell you.
Oh, you want warm-up.
There's a place in Newton.
I know where that is.
Terry O'Reilly.
See, I did not know that, but you told me. See, it's amazing.
You
see how you get answers out of people?
Same guy.
Wow. That's awesome. So we'll bring cameras down and film it, and we'll do the whole thing.
That'll be our next episode.
So our next episode is going to be
three Arnie episodes in a row.
Three Arnie episodes. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Okay. But our next, you know what our next episode is?
No, I have no clue.
No. Our next episode of Behind the Curtain.
Is?
Improv!
Oh, good Lord.
Improv! We're going to have an improv
night.
Again.
Cool.
Could be, yes. We're going to invite some people.
You edit a lot, I assume.
Yes, we go out, we go crazy. We have an improv game that we play. And we're going to have a bunch of people coming down. I think we got at least 6 or 7. If you guys are interested in trying improv, that's an open night.
PG or just G?
It's PG.
PG.
Oh, good. PG. There was definitely
like
probing going on.
Yeah, okay.
There you go.
You
can do the music.
You can do the music.
I don't want to know.
Well, thank you, everybody. And thank you for writing such a wonderful scene.
Yes,
and being
you.
In
was
it,
fun.
It was such a fun thing to do. So until next time, I'm Behind the Curtain. I'm Joe White.
And I'm Katy Shander-Reynolds.